Prime Minister is simply out of touch with everyday Canadians, right, which is why he found it so easy to cut their take-home pay by raising payroll taxes, take away their tax credits for textbooks, transit and kids, arts and sports, and slap a carbon tax on everything, making their gas, groceries and heating bills soar. Canadian families don't have a trust fund to fall back on, and under this government, they're struggling just to make ends meet. So why is this Prime Minister so hell-bent on making their lives more expensive?
Right, Honourable Prime Minister.
4 years later, Mr. Speaker, and the Conservatives are still reduced to personal attacks and inventing things, Mr. Speaker. The first thing we did was lower taxes on the middle class and raise them on the wealthiest 1%. We then delivered a Canada Child benefit that helps 9 out of 10 Canadian families with hundreds of dollars tax-free every month, has lifted 300,000 kids out of poverty as part of our plans that have lifted 800,000 Canadians out of poverty. We've continued to grow the economy with over 1 million new jobs while at the same time having a low...
The Honourable Member for Chilliwack-Hope.
Well, Mr. Speaker, the facts don't lie. Half of Canadian families are within $200 of not being able to pay their bills each month. A third of Canadian families are unable to cover their payments and are falling further into debt. The Prime Minister's never had to worry about his own money, but Canadian families do. They don't have an extra $60 to pay for a pack of boxed water, and they certainly can't afford $1.60 a litre for gas. And when will this out-of-touch Prime Minister stop making life more expensive for Canadian families who, under this government, are just struggling to get by?
The Right Honourable Prime Minister.
The member opposite likes to talk about facts. Let's talk about some facts. Fact: the lowest unemployment rate in Canada in 40 years. Fact: Canadians have created 1 million jobs over the past 4 years. Fact: 300,000 kids lifted out of poverty. Fact: 825,000 Canadians lifted out of poverty. Investments in communities, investments that have made lives more affordable and better for Canadians from coast to coast to coast. That's a